Right, I know I said this last year, but I am going to say it again. We have got to get going up this league. Our first two games are against teams that finished in the top four last season. Great. Exactly what we wanted. Hello then, guys. Welcome back. My name is David, and welcome back to another episode of Going Intercontinental. We are back for the first two league games of the season, and as you just heard, we're up against River and we're up against Racing Club. The first thing I wanted to bring to your awareness is the fact that it really, for some reason, says first phase on the competition screen. I have no idea what that means. It was also worth noting that the bottom three get relegated into the Nacional B division at the end of this season. So presumably that is now away from the fact that it used to be just the bottom three on average points. I can't see anywhere, as you probably can't either, where it says about average points. So I assume that's been scrapped by the looks of it anyway. So yeah, we'll see how it goes. It's 40 games each, so we're going to play everyone twice, 40-game season. Season preview-wise, we're still ninth, if I remember correctly. I don't think anything's changed. No, we've not changed. We've not gone better in odds, not got worse. The European sides are now 100% starting to pinch all of the players in this division now. Interestingly, I can't remember who it was. I think it was Independiente signed Casasola, who we had on loan to us last year. Was it him? Was it them? Yeah, you go. Thiago Casasola, they signed him. In hindsight, I probably should have played a bit more, but I had three good right backs anyway, and I'm never playing someone who plays as a no-nonsense fullback. Get out of town. Fullback at worst, wing back ideally, not playing a no-nonsense fullback, get out of town, sunshine. So he is with them. But yeah, games for this one, as I mentioned, are going to be against, where are they gone? Further up, River and Racing Club. Also, from the end of October, we have no games until January. So we have a nice big old winter break. I don't know what that means. It's all changing year on year and I can't keep up with it. But without further ado, let's get into the first game. I've just realised I haven't picked my team, although it has picked me something already, although I am going to make the change that you're probably expecting, which will be Benitez to come in instead of Batistuta now that he is no longer suspended. Actually, I'm going to do this because otherwise it's going to keep me with 12 substitutes and he gets a bit pissy when I do that. So let's do this then. We're going to put Belmonte in. I think we'll keep the squad as it is, actually, because what is Torres? Torres is on the bench, but I do want to give a lot more playing time to Hector Nora, because he's really starting to become a very, very good-looking player. And the good thing is we can now, again, as we did in the Cup game against Lanús, which you didn't see, we can play Grasa and Fernandez alongside each other. So team for this game is going to be Limassan in goal, Ferroni, Ricardo Grasa, Fernandez and Steve Hood, the back four. Fernandez supporting Nora and Belmonte, sorry, Julian Fernandez supporting Hector Nora and Thomas Belmonte in the centre of the park. And then we have Aguirre and Benitez supporting Varela up top. I've just realised that, what's his face? Zavios isn't in the squad. He's on the bench. Sorry, yeah, he is. I thought so. I was going to say, I was going to put in Varela anyway, because obviously he has been playing a little bit better. So without any further ado, let's get into the game and let's see how we get on. We are at home. Obviously, first game of the season. Like I say, first phase, whatever that means. We are slightly offset to the teams that have already played a game because we played in the third round of the Sudamericana. So we are slightly off. So we're a bit further down the lead than we normally be because of that. But yeah, we'll get stuck in and let's see if we can get a result against these boys. Obviously, I'm pretty sure this time in the last season, towards the end of the year, we did get a 2-0 win away from home against these guys and Varela got on the score sheet. And I think it was Belmonte got on the score sheet as well. So fingers crossed we can do something similar. In fact, aside from Gratha being in the squad, it's probably, and Nora being in the team, it's probably a very, very similar looking side to the one that played against them before. Also newly on the bench is this guy, Oscar Fernandez. He is looking like a very decent potential centre forward. He has come on as slash attacking midfielder, as you can see. His media description is attacking midfielder, so he can play in a couple of different positions. Hopefully we can get something out of him, but yeah, he's come in as he's been doing quite well over the last couple of weeks and months in training. But Steve Hood with a throw, and then to Varela, who's going to get it to Aguirre, who has a chance early doors, and that's a good chance. It was an absolute sitter, apparently. I'm not sure I fully agree with that. But Varela's now going to be on the corner. He's going to get a ball into Ricardo Graffa at the front, at the near post, straight at the keeper. You have to let me know if you still want me to call him Ricardo Graffa or call him just Ricardo Grasser. I don't know what you prefer. Do think of myself as a bit of a wordsman when it comes to pronunciations, but you guys be the judge of that. If there's any Argentinians or Spanish or whatever watching, then let me know. Fernandez with a chance to throw in again straight at the keeper, but we are having a lot of chances in this first half. Safe to say we've had a lot of the clearer chances anyway. Steve Hood with a lovely commanding header there, and Benitez is putting him under a lot of pressure. He's managed to get the ball off him, so he's going to try and break free now. He's going to try and play it through. He's run straight for the defence. He's going to have a chance. Just kind of trickles towards the keeper, to be honest. So not the best in the world. And this looks like it could be an interesting one. Steve to Fernandez, back to Steve, who plays it to the keeper, which is always a bit concerning. Does go to River, who are now on the charge again, which is very concerning. But Belmonte's nicked that ball. That's a lovely interception. He's played that very nicely. Gets it to Nora, to Ferroni, who's going to play to Aguirre. He's going to surely put a cross into Benitez, the back post, and it's 1-0. And we're 1-0 up in the new season, and that is exactly the way I would have wanted this to start. I am very, very pleased with this indeed. Lovely bit of interplay there. Aguirre's got plenty of space, and it's his first assist. And Benitez lurking with no one marking him at the back post. And it is 1-0 to Newell's Old Boys. Puts up into ninth in the league. Obviously, as you can see, we've got played two or three games themselves. New team up in this year is this Independiente Rivadavia. I think they're the only team that did go up. I can't see anyone else in here. Not that's playing right now anyway, so I don't. There might have been one more. I honestly can't remember. Don't get complacent out there. Let's do that. If we can get off to a nice start to the season again, hopefully we can just push on. Obviously, form and morale being very, very important in this Football Manager game this year, as I've heard from quite a few people, actually. But getting a win to start off the season would be a very good start indeed. Amazingly, Independiente have won one game. They're losing this one 3-1 to Juniors. And within two games, they've scored six and conceded five. That's quite something. A throw-in for River then. Got past his man, which is a bit of a concern. Now, lovely little block there from, I think that was Grasser who's got in the way there. He managed to get that. Putting him under a lot of pressure. I do like the little the pushing forward that we're doing, pushing it right back to the keeper, which is lovely. Can Varela do what he did in the last episode? He cannot. We are putting them under a lot of pressure, but they are playing well. They're certainly making chances. Steve's gone very, very far wide there. That's given him a bit of space. Alvarez, oh, lovely save. Oh, how has he got it in from there? That should not be going in from that angle. I'm sorry, but just no. That shouldn't be happening. And that's a goal that we really shouldn't be conceding. I've got to be on it. Look at that. Limusan's got to be covering that, I'm afraid. If anything, I mean, he shouldn't have really even put it back into play, but let him off on that one, but he really shouldn't have been. Should have been saving that. I'm sorry. Maybe that's harsh on me, I don't know. Let me know what you think, but I personally think he should have been doing better, as Benitez has a shot that just goes wide of the post. He's looking lively in this game. Steve Hood not having the best of games. I demand more from the boys, because we have outplayed them so far, I think. They are starting to get their way back into the game, but I feel we deserve a lot more than what we have at the moment. That's it. I suppose it's just one of them, isn't it? You've got to take your chances. Time for a couple of changes, I think. We'll bring off Belmonte. Not had a best of games. No, we'll bring on Torres, who can play as an advanced playmaker there. I'll leave that. I quite like the idea of having the defensive and the deep lying and the advanced playmaker. Where can Fernandez play? What's his position preference? So he plays as a winger and a centre forward. So we could potentially bring him on. We'll keep an eye out for him. In the meantime, I think what I'm going to do is just bring on Andreozzi on for Steve, who, as I mentioned, is not having the best of games. As you can see, we haven't been able to ship out Nadalan, so he is still with us for at least the foreseeable future. Whether that will change or not, I don't know. I don't see it changing this season. Maybe we can get him out on loan, I don't know. But yeah, like I said, I'm not hugely concerned. It does mean that we've got that extra bit of backup if we need it. As you can see, the boys are playing well, just not had a chance to get that extra goal, which is a bit of a shame. And this worries me. I hate it when the highlight starts there, but lovely little ball across to Benitez, plays it to Aguirre, doesn't quite get to it. And this is where I don't like these highlights, because now Alvarez is going to go in and score. Limassan with a save. You notice I've started telling the system, telling the game they're going to score, and hopefully it puts them away. They're going to score from this corner, though, 100%. Oh, Limassan, what a save. Kept a hold of it nicely. Really, I would have hoped he'd gone for the quick clearance and got it to Aguirre, but he's got it again. That's a lovely claim. Really good in the air, that man. Play it. That's it. Aguirre's got it this time. That's what I wanted him to do the last time. Takes a shot, though, and I really don't know what he was doing there. That's a really disappointing decision from that man. Obviously, he is playing subject to the fact that Barotha is currently out injured. We should probably make one more change. I'm not entirely sure who it's going to be. No one's really played that badly, to be completely honest with you. I think I'll bring on Ceballos instead of Varela. Just to, freshen it up top and see if we can get a different side of the game going. See, Jesus, I've just looked at River playing three up front. I think they're playing a 3-4-3 by the looks of it, which is something I've not seen many times. See, a lot of these teams, not necessarily as strong as they would have been due to the fact that these European teams have obviously come in and taken a lot of their players. But this is going to be 2-1 here. We're going to lose this game, I think. Oh, what a save by Limassan. Pick that man out. Give him the man of the match. He's had an absolute stormer aside from that goal that he's conceded. But we are under the cosh, because to be the best way to explain it. River have got another chance. I think, oh, Benitez nicked it off him, though. That's a lovely little challenge there. Where's he going to go with it? Oh, he's just lost it. He just slowed down and just... Oh, Fernandez! Oh, get out! What has happened there? What has happened there? That was a shocking, shocking bit of positioning. Look at that. Just drop back, you bell end. Oh, we've lost that because of a horrendous mistake from Fernandez. That was absolutely shocking. Going to go very attacking for the rest of the game, just see if we can get back into it. But that was a very, very disappointing mistake. And it looks like it's going to be an unfortunate defeat to start the season, which is all the more annoying because we were obviously leading at one point. But I'm going to say two individual errors, because that error from Fernandez was worse than the error from Limassan, 100%. Limassan didn't cover himself in glory, but Fernandez had an absolute shocker. Can we say anything to him? I can't really say I'm not happy with his performance individually, because he'd still got 6.8, but he really, really should have done better there. Aguirre having a great game in the second half, though. So we're off to the start of the game. We're start of the league, and we're 18. But I'm not concerned. I'm not worried about that at the moment. We did collapse. There you go. Not much you can do about it, unfortunately. We'll move on to the next game, which is in... I can't remember how much game time. In just over... Oh, yeah, we've got loads of games. Look at this. Wait, hold on a minute. You're having a laugh. Sunday, Wednesday, Sunday, Wednesday, Sunday, Wednesday, Sunday. There's a week between... So there's a week between the games against Tucumán and Talleres, and that's it. Until September. That is unbelievable. We're going to be rotating a lot, and I think we're going to see a rotated side against Racing Club coming up next. Okay then, guys, welcome back. It's time for the second game of the episode. Obviously, this one against Racing Club. We're away from home. They are another team that has not won their first game, and they haven't obviously played since we did, because we played our game, 3 days ago? As you can see, a couple of changes to the side. So we do have Kano coming in and making his debut for the club. Just to give him a bit of a chance to run out. I kept Ferroni on the bench just in case he either has a shocker or just isn't really kind of fully up to fitness. Obviously, he's lacking that match sharpness, but I need two ways to get it up. Get him in the reserves, which I don't really want to do, or put him in the team. But yeah, we have Limassan in goal, Kano, Graza, Fernandez and Steve Hood at the back four. Fernandez supporting Nora and Torres in the midfield positions, who has replaced the outgoing Belmonte, who has actually just recently rejected a contract from the club. That's not why I've taken him out. I just want to keep him fresh and I want to give Nora a bit more game time. We then have Aguirre and Benitez, who are, of course, supporting Varela up front. We've also had a couple of loan offers in for Tobias Donsanti, who you will maybe remember from the wing/centre-forward position. He's not going to get game time here. he's still got a decent amount of potential, so we'd get him out on loan. So we had a couple of teams who've come in and are willing to pay all of his wages, which is absolutely fine. Otherwise, not a huge amount has changed, apart from the fact that I have offered Nadalan back out for 5 million, which has generated a bit of interest. 5 million is probably a bit of a stretch, to be completely honest with you. I'm probably expecting to get something more in the 3 to 4 million pound region. I'm mainly doing that to obviously get him off the wage budget where possible and try and offset some of the spending that we've done on both infrastructure and transfers this season. So there's your quick little couple of days update. It's amazing what can happen in a couple of days, but we have Aguirre on chance now. Gets the ball in. Hasn't managed to get to his man, but it's a lovely little run from him. He's looking very, very tidy in this first couple of games, which I'm very pleased with. But every time I say that, they end up doing something horribly wrong. So cue the 6.3 rated game. Benitez the chance, dribbles it towards the keeper. Doesn't manage to get too much on it. Let's check. Yeah, Racing Club. Oh, yeah, they're underneath us. Very similar result in the first game. Not sure who they lost to. Didn't quite manage to check that out, but Benitez managed to round his man quite nicely. He's got Hood in support. He's going to take another chance. He's taking a lot of chances at the moment. He's not really doing much of them. I would have preferred if he'd have given that to someone else, to be honest, but it's early doors. Still plenty of time. Racing Club now with a chance. Limassan with a fantastic claim. He's doing really good in the air so far, which is very nice to see. What we want. Not the best of clearances, though, and it's going to give Racing Club the chance to get on the front foot. So they're going to get a ball out to Valalba, who's going to presumably Arcana with a good challenge there. Puts a ball in, though, at the second time of asking, and as you'd expect, ball comes in. It was always going in, wasn't it? Damien Fernandez missed his header and was made to pay for it. Where have you seen that before? As if he does miss his header. That's him, I think, just underneath my mouse. He didn't miss his header, he didn't jump. Simple as that. I'm not sure why he didn't, but maybe he was drawn by the fact that the other player for Racing Club didn't jump. I don't know. But not the most fruitful of starts. And another corner for Racing Club, and they've scored. Is it an own goal? Yeah, it's an own goal, I think. Own goal, Ricardo Graza. So within the space of 15 minutes, in fact, I'm not even going to call it the space of 15 minutes, within the space of 5 minutes, they had two defensive mistakes from the two players who I was very, 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 very pleased to have in the squad for the new season. Yeah. Anyway, let's move swiftly away from that, shall we? We definitely need to get back into this game, although I'm pretty sure this game is already well out of our reach. We're away to one of the better clubs in the league. We are 2-0 down. We're not winning this game. We'll do very well to get back to a draw, but even then, I still think that's out of reach. And you can see, even for the first for that game, Kano is continuing to make me happy that I did put Ferroni on the bench. Fernandez has a chance of going over. Never going in that. Far too far away. Fernandez with a 6.3. Kano with a 6.3. Front three with a 6.5, apart from the fact that Benitez just pulled that up by a point, and it's just not really gone very well. Room for improvement. Kano's got worse. Everyone's playing really badly. Tell the team this is disappointing. I can't do much else than that. I can't even tell them I've got faith in them. Do you know what? Go out there and show them what you're capable of. Prove a point. Because that's what you need to do. You are better than this. You, me, the viewers, they know you're better than this. All four of the viewers. Right, come on. Early goal and we're back in it. The only team that's beneath us is the team that got promoted and they've conceded 10 goals in 3 games. What's going on? Why isn't there any highlights? Why is nothing happening? Why are a couple of you apprehensive and anxious? Like, pull your finger out. Right, Benitez, get off my football pitch. You are not fit to wear this shirt. A spell in the reserves might do you good, young man. He's not young. I think he's like 28, 29. Older than me. In this he is, anyway. Who else is coming off? Do you know what, Kano? You tried your best. It's not worked out in your first game. Let's get you out of the cauldron. Let's bring Ferroni on. A bit more experience. Maybe not necessarily in terms of age, but definitely in terms of actual game time, at least for Newell's. And yeah, let's get him out of the firing line before he gets pelted with missiles from the fans who are not particularly impressed. Ball in from Nora, doesn't get to anyone. Fernandez gets it back though, gives it back to Nora, who's on the left-hand side, to Gratha with a ball in, and it's the one person you probably don't want on your crosses, your centre-half. But there you go. Fernandez managed to get the ball though, nods it to Varela, who's going to run with it. And that is the worst chance, and that's him coming off right now. Only made those changes 3 minutes ago, but that has got to be one of the worst things I've ever seen. So Ceballos is coming on. Shorken. That was awful. Absolutely terrible. So he has no excuse to stay on the pitch as far as I'm concerned. I thought it was a chance. Twas not. Okay. Rotation is not something that I should be doing by the seams of it. Nora with a free kick now. Ball in. Straight at the keeper. Right at the keeper. It was in the keeper, literally in the keeper's breadbasket. He had to walk forward about three steps and he had the ball. Which is not good. Gratha with the ball again now. Loses it nearly. Gives it to Steve, who's going to give it to Fernandez, who's the furthest back. Gives it to Ceballos, though. Has a chance. It's the post, but he was offside. The only bit of solace I can take out of this is the fact that the only player who is still playing badly is Torres. Everyone else has, in fact, pulled their finger out to an extent. Limassan has been my star player so far, apart from that little mistake he did in the first game against River, because I take it back. He's terrible. What was that? Practically gave it to the Racing player. And he claims it again. Don't do it again. Jeepers. Their keeper's got to say, look at this. All of their key players have got the spine of their team, pretty much, have had a decent rating. I'm not sure what position Ojeda plays in, but not good enough. Grasso with a commanding header. Why is no one coming out to it? That ball went so slowly. Fernandez now with the ball. Tries to play it through to Ceballos, so I'm 99% sure he's offside. It doesn't matter because he can't put the bloody thing in anyway. We've actually played better in the second half, but we've still somehow played really badly. I don't know how that's physically possible. Could be a significant result. It's a significantly poor result from us. Predicted a Racing Club win. That's what I mean. I predicted a win. Hold on a minute. Tell them the boys are excellent. No. That first half was abysmal. Don't get me wrong, it's not you're back into training terrible, apart from maybe them three, but it wasn't excellent. Get out of town. Do you know what, actually? Right, do you know what? Hold on a minute. Who are you? You've been here for a while. I'm not sure you're cut up to scratch anymore. You've been my assistant manager the entire time. I'm gonna start having a look, you know. I don't think he fully understands what he's doing. Let's go and have a look. Right, assistant manager. Highlight key attributes. Assistant manager. Can we get anyone who's got 15 minimum for all of them? It says one person found. Two people. Here we go. This is a bit more like it. Pablo Manusevic. Who's this guy then? Do you know what? By the name, I knew he'd been at Lanús recently. I don't know why. See, this is the kind of guy I'm after. Let's give this man a contract. Let's approach this chap. He wants a lot of money. Will you go a K less? Will you go £900 less? Will you go £800 less? Will you go £700 less? I could do this all day. He's not going to do it, is he? No. Well, that one's out the window. I suppose it's this guy then. Claudio Cristofanelli. He's pretty much bang on for all of those anyway. So he's my next chance. Right, here we go then. Oh, see, this is much more my ballpark. £1,100 a week. Cheaper than our current geezer, Mr. Ciccatello. And there you go. Job done. Let's hope he comes in and he sorts things out. Right then, that brings us to the end of this episode for today. What we will do is I'm going to do the next five or six games. And then we'll come back for the game against New Boys Independiente Rivadavia in the hope that we can actually get a win out of that game. And probably, actually, I was going to say the Rosario game, but I think what we'll do is we'll bring you back for the Copa Argentina 7th round game as well. So we'll do that one, we'll go offline for that, and then we'll come back for the Cup game after that as well. Because to be honest, I'm going to focus on the cup for that one, unless we're doing wonders in the league, in which case I'll play a full strength side. But I'll probably play full strength against them, rotate against Rosario, and then play full strength against San Martin and just completely smack them. That's the idea. But anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching, as always. If you have enjoyed it, then make sure you smash that like button. That'd be very much appreciated. Gets the old algorithms churning. If you're new around here, then make sure you subscribe. There's loads of these videos coming out on a regular basis. And let me know what you think in the comments as well about how we're getting on in. Maybe ways that we can improve our fortunes since the turn of the year. But anyway, guys, yeah, thanks for watching. My name's been David, and I'll catch you guys next time. Bye-bye.